Hey guys, so today I am working on a sort of tan colored paper. I'm not sure what kind of paper this is. It might be Stonehenge, but I can't remember. And I sort of wanted to do a background that is a view from the sky. I was really inspired by some watercolor map paintings, but I thought hand painting each shape might have been a little bit too intricate. Totally not outside my realm of habit, obviously, but I thought I might as well make use of this masking fluid that Grey Wren sent me. Shout out to Grey Wren, thank you so much. It's definitely come in handy today. And the fluid itself doesn't seem to last forever. It does solidify a little bit in the bottle, so I don't want to just leave it there to rot. I want to actually make use of it. I took a satellite picture from Google Maps. I guess it wasn't a satellite picture, it was just a regular map picture. And I didn't really replicate it exactly. I tried to get it as close as possible, but when it came to little side streets and stuff, I did kind of take some liberties with that. And I gotta tell you, this actually was surprisingly painstaking. A lot of the time was actually spent trying to keep my bearings and figure out where I was on the map, because I was trying to get it somewhat the same. And I must have spent at least an hour doing this. It took longer than I thought it was going to take. I used a cheap paintbrush with dish soap on it so that the masking fluid just wipes right off at the end when it builds up in big gobs. I can just pull it off and keep going. It's a lot easier than using a stick. And I painted the background using squares of watercolor. I'm just picking colors that I like. I like warm colors, so I stuck with that, even though I knew that that was going to be a little bit problematic because things that are in the background should be cool colors, and maybe I would have had less trouble later if I had followed that rule. But you know, I'm kind of stubborn and I really like warm colors, so. And I wasn't really going for realism, so here we go. I did a bunch of colors until I felt like it was rich enough. Some things were not recorded because, you know, the card fills up or the camera overheats or I just don't feel like it, or I feel like I'm done and then I just keep going. I tried to tone it down with a white ink spray, which worked a lot better than I remember it worked. So it made it very speckly and interesting. Oh, and I've got a molding paste in the background as well for texture. Once I start pulling this off, you'll see that the lines were not compromised by the texture underneath them. It worked just fine. Really aggravates me though is that I painted those purple squares before I put the map on because I forgot that that was what I was doing. So annoying, but it didn't really affect the end product. So there's a theme show that happens every year, and this year the theme is chairs. The themes are not inspiring. I don't know what I'm supposed to get from the word chair. That is so interesting, you know, to make a painting from a chair. I don't know. I didn't know what I was going to do. I thought about it for so long until I thought of a song. I was at work and I was just humming. It was an old Our Lady Peace song. I think it's called The Beautiful Future. I can't remember even. Anyway, it's the lyrics go, she builds her own satellite from an old rusty chair, which was always kind of an interesting image to me. You know, when I think about that song now, I'm sure that it was a metaphor for other things. I don't know, but I decided to take it literally and build my own satellite using an old rusted chair. And I just happen to know somebody who has an old rusted chair in their backyard, and it is a very, very interesting chair, so I'm using that chair. And I started to build it kind of seriously. I had the cube set tucked between the legs, and when it came to making the solar panels, and I also added an antenna in there for no reason, I also started thinking, well, she's starting with a rusted chair. She's not going to have fancy satellite parts either, right? So I decided that the solar panels are going to be made from window shutters, and the solar panels themselves were going to be from hundreds of old elementary school calculators. You know, those old little solar panel pieces that keep your calculator running I decided, well, this character's just gonna rip out solar panels from 100 little calculators and somehow wire those up to the cube somehow, because I thought that that would be more fun and more interesting. I also decided that the antenna was going to be made from an old umbrella with the handle torn off. I don't think that's really apparent in the finished piece, but that's okay. It's there, it's cute, it looks like an antenna, so I'm happy. And because I don't really like painting people that much, not for like difficulty reasons or anything like that, I just don't know who to paint. I don't want to paint myself. You know, I don't want to put myself in all my paintings. It feels kind of weird. And I don't want to paint strangers. I don't want to use stock images of models. I don't want to try to invent a person from my imagination and then that person just happens to look like somebody real and they look at my painting and think, is that me? I just have a tendency to avoid painting likenesses of actual people. That's why I paint a lot of animals in human situations, you know, going to the market or having protests in the street. They're all animals. They represent people, but it's just, it's easier for me and it's more whimsical and fun. So on a whim, I just painted a cat in an astronaut suit. He's got little cat ears sticking out. He's mostly obscured by the solar panel in the end, but it's there and it's kind of weird. Is this technically a character? Did I create a cat astronaut character? I'm kind of excited about that because I didn't really like how this painting turned out. I thought that the colors were too samey. I don't think the satellite character sticks out very well from the background. I think it's all very busy. Cube satellites don't they aren't this close to the Earth. They are in low orbit, but they aren't like plane height, right? I decided to just give clouds a try. I think it did help a little bit, but I don't particularly like it, you know? It's very childlike to me. It looks a little bit like a child's idea, and I'm feeling kind of self-conscious about it, and I'm not sure if I'm actually gonna go with it. Which is why I'm kind of excited about the idea of having just created a cat astronaut character in a homemade cube satellite, which means that I could just do this again. I could continue to make this character travel into different worlds, and I could make weird worlds. I could send him out into space. I can send him to Venus, and then we can finally find out what's on the surface of Venus, because I'm really curious. I don't know if other people spend nearly as much time as I do thinking about what Venus looks like beyond all the clouds. But, you know, I'm seeing a lot of possibilities with this cat satellite, and I'm digging it. I'm thinking maybe I should just make a little series. If I need an idea, I can just go back and send the cat satellite somewhere else. It needs some kind of, name. I don't know. Maybe we'll just have to add more things to his cube satellite. Maybe replace some parts that break, get into some conflicts, come across some aliens, you know? It'd be really fun. I think you can make a whole zine out of this, so. This is not the end of Cat CubeSat, alright? So yeah, in conclusion, I think I have an idea that has a bit of potential. I'm not sure if it's chair enough to submit to the theme show, or even if it's really skilled enough, you know, because you're competing with other people. So I might have to play with Cat CubeSat a little bit longer. And hopefully it doesn't fizzle out of existence like a lot of my other ideas. Anyway, yeah, let me know what you think, what maybe you would have done to fix the problem that I had that I didn't think of. I don't know. Maybe you have some clever idea of where I should send Cat CubeSat. Or if I should give him a less weird name. Anyway, thank you for watching this video, and I will see you next time.